Okay, my name's Danbert Nobacon. I've almost lived in the US for 10 years, not quite, but and I live in Twisp, which is over the mountains, like 5 hours today. But yeah, so Seattle is the biggest city. So I come to Seattle anyway. Anyway, so I have a new record, which I have done a record that is an album for 7 years. So there's some cards about it here. And it was recorded in Seattle, in Delridge, off the West Seattle Bridge. And late last year, actually, and I was supposed to be done recording by the end of October, but it inevitably went over schedule, and then the election happened, and well, we all know about that. But anyway, but it gave me the chance to say something about what was going on post-Obama kind of thing. Okay, anyway, so we'll get to that, but this is an older song. Society wedding, East Coast and Betty. The military marries into green. The
green and it's a blowing. Let's all get blasted. Enjoy it while it lasts. Ronald Reagan raises his glass to the best of public lunch by the ruling class. A happy couple already in the past. Thank you.
Okay, so this new record, it's called Stardust to Darwinstuff, the stuff of life, kind of. So, it, you know, and obviously I wrote the songs, a lot of them, way before last November. And I realised that a lot of my songs in recent years, because I read books, in fact, I worked here, Quinn knows this, I worked in Left Bank Books for one day because... I think it was 5 or 6 years ago. I had a book, a young adult novel, and I was trying to remember the story, and my publisher said, oh, Sherman Alexis sent this thing out to authors and independent bookstores. So the day after Black Friday, which is Small Business Saturday, apparently, he wants people to go and volunteer in the local indie bookstore or whatever. And so we set it up and I came, and Quinn showed me how to use the cash register because I've never used one. I've never used one since. anyway, where was I? So, and I found this book in this store, actually, and it's called On the Origins of Stories, and it's by a guy called Brian Boyd, and he's New Zealand, from New Zealand, and it's about why we evolved to tell stories, basically. What possible use could that be? Anyway, and... I only just realised this, but so I'm going to change my plan here. One of the songs on the record mentions Brian Boyd, and I wrote to him. I said, I've put your name in this song. And there's another scientist on it called Ellen Disanayake, who teaches in Washington. And they're into, you know, the why we evolved art, basically. And did it help us survive? And it probably did, and it probably still will. Anyway, so this song, you know, is one that I rejigged because of the election. And it's an older song, but we managed to lift the old tracks and I kind of rewrote the lyrics. Anyway, so the album has all these science themes running through it. This one came out on the inauguration. Okay. Did it come to this? Where did we go from here? When the oligarch knows better than all the world scientists, I step from mama now, we're back down to margarita. As if the rest of us will take this lion down. So I propose a toast. John Scowell, Brian Boyd, Ellen Disanayake, the old world's done forget to choose. Two companies, when we came from, and we got here and where we found. But I cursed the mixer of the land we were in, man. With everything that's in my gun, in my mind.
so of course I can't read my set list, but anyway.
Okay, so title track. Okay, we'll go with that. So where I live out in rural Washington, it's kind of cool because, you know, we have snow. We have four seasons still, and that's interesting. And being from England, there's like big wildlife that we don't have in England, which is kind of cool. Also, there's a lot of biologists out there and artists. Anyway, and the stars at night are fantastic if there's no clouds, because there's no street lights to speak of. And so the meteor shower we get in August. Anyway, this, yeah. Remember the first line of the song I've been playing. It'll come back to me. Anyway, this sometimes happens, as you guys who played know. Sometimes the brain doesn't quite work like it does when you're just playing at home in your bedroom. Anyway, we'll come back to that. Okay, so with another old song, but it's funny, I have these old songs and the last record 7 years ago, and then I did one 10 years ago. Then I have songs from way back. And some of, I don't know if things go in cycles, but some of those songs suddenly have new relevance. This is one of my songs that was in a car wreck with one of Hank Williams' songs. People wonder, well, I'm from Northern England, why do I sing old country songs, which I do sometimes. And my dad had a radio show where he played them, so I grew up with them. Anyway. I can settle down and do just fine till I hear the breeze blow down.
Is my life. that old devil kerosene. If it's good enough for that, but then it's good for me. That old devil kerosene, you and me, and one Mr. Kerosene. That's a my battery, amen, for me. When I'm gone and let my craving stand, take a twist on me, pocket knife, make an incision above my right hand.
That song off that record was it was kind of a fictional sci-fi record in the near future, which is not so distant away, and unfortunately some of it seems to be coming true, like not wiretapping Obama, wiretapping Trump, but the WikiLeaks, you know, CIA can turn your cell phone into a monitor kind of thing. In the story, the guy, the protagonist, he kind of works out how to, like you have on your phone, you can, the camera, you hit the switch and it reflects back and you take a selfie. And he works out how to do that. So he can hear them as they're listening to him kind of thing. And then also he finds a way to tap into all these other leads, feeds what they've got going on. And it's like Rear Window. I don't know if you know the Alfred Hitchcock movie, but it for the digital age, because he can just, anyway. So, so what's he doing? Well, it looks like he's doing a show. I know that, but he's not even any good. Why are we sat here doing this again? I mean, we're not getting anything. Well, we do get paid rather handsomely too. Okay, mommy and child.
Mommy, yeah, well, today at nursery, this boy is a boy, Michael. He said, Trumpy.
Annabelle, darling, we don't say the T word.
No, but he said Trumpy like Action Man. He not like Action Man, mommy. No. Because when he uses his words, well, a big fib comes out of his mouth, mommy. He's an Action Man. I know, Action Man got chin pie. He's a boy doll, a doll for boys. He got chin pie like your boyfriend, mommy. Yeah. Anyway, he's more like, I know, he's old. He's old like Grandpa. But he's more like a bad clown creepy. Yeah, he's a bad clown creepy, mommy. Because the fib come out of his mouth, he's not Action Man, he's more like Gumby. He bend everywhere, he bend all over the place, mommy. Yeah.
It's just part of the Rear Window perspective, the digital Rear Window. Anyway, okay, we'll try the title track again. This is because I forgot to bring a beer. Yeah. was like, I don't know if you know the Seattle band, The Bad Things, and some singers and some people from where I live in Twist, like 15 people on it. So it's always way better with more, it seems. Anyway.
Okay. Where were we?
So this is another one off the record. Another, the idea of the record and the theme is like, well, this, as science tells us, this amazing place we call home and everything about it, which took billions of years for us to be able to appreciate it, and heavy machinery or weaponry can destroy an ecosystem in a matter of hours, and it's kind of really messed up. Anyway, and even more messed up with the current crop of governance, as you're probably all aware. Anyway.
But Mummy, Jennifer at nursery, she said her dad, she got a daddy, Mummy. Her dad says he's a lawman.
Do you mean he's a policeman, Annabelle?
No, he's a lawman. He knows things. Yeah, he said, you know, illegal. What bad clown creepy doing it and illegal?
I think you mean, what do you mean?
You know, Mummy, when a bald eagle gets poorly in his tummy, an illegal. And, but Trumpy, he don't have a bald eagle. It's not in his tummy, it's in his brain. It pecking at his brain. And so when he uses words, Mummy, like when he uses his words, it come out as a fib, a big fib. Yeah. And an illegal, you know that? Yeah.
wait. Okay, another.
Some form or other, and we go back there, but not all of it. Some of them are, you know, human emotion, love, heartbreak, etc. You know about it probably. Anyway. So it hurts. So imperfect.
so damaged, so deep inside. Ooh, but when you smile, love finding its way. So I know.
Into the archives, and this one obviously was written in England in the 1980s. If any of you were any of you born back then, I'm sure some of you were. Anyway, so that's no disrespect, you know. So Thatcher's Britain, we call it Thatcher's Britain. Anyway, I adapted it, and I'll tell you why after. Okay.
I am a Republican representative, and so am I, and so am I. And I'm a wavering Democrat, and we are here to help. To pass laws, to make decisions that help. To help our friends to the wealth, and ourselves, our future selves to the wealth. Do you agree with me? Order! Do you agree? Order! Order! We agree. Very well, we should do very well. Ha, ha, hip hooray, what a wonderful day. Our declaration of war from today. We'll fight the war against the people, against the poor. But remember, we don't call it war. We call it the law.
Anyway, so... So living out in Twit, since January 17th or whenever it was, I have never seen in all the generations Thatcher's Britain, Bill Clinton, you know, Bush the Elder, Bush the Younger, Obama. I have never seen so many people who want to get, they're so pissed, they want to do something. And a lot of people, and I've never done this before, you know, ring your local representative. You know, and you get like the answer message, or you know, oh, he's doing a town. No, he's not. He didn't come to the town hall. Obviously, there's like 400 people there, but he didn't come to the town hall. Oh, but then, like, I'm just cooking dinner. I have twins who are 17. Okay, a boy and a girl, and they're just coming from school. I'm cooking, and the phone rings, and I'm on some list somewhere. So it's and our Republican representative is called Dan Newhouse. Okay, and it's right. Oh, he's doing a phone in for an hour. so you can ask your questions. So, you know, you press whatever and you're in the queue. But he does it for an hour. And basically, as a lot of people locally who know way better than me, he just talked to his friends. He screened it, whatever, just talked to his friends, ignored all the questions. By bizarre coincidence, my children, they go to high school. I teach at their high school, actually. But anyway, that's an aside. They do this thing every year, and it's called Close Up. And they like fundraise for fall and winter, save up, and they go on a trip to Washington, D.C., you know, and they see how government works, and they look at the monuments, go to museums. Anyway, so I get it. They've gone to D.C. in March, and I get a text from my daughter. Oh, Dad, we're meeting Dan Newhouse tomorrow for 45 minutes. And I'm like furiously typing questions. And some of the other moms and parents are doing the same because there were like 20 of our students went. And so the next day, we're all like on edge. Did you meet Dan Newhouse? Okay, yeah, we met him. But he was 15 minutes late. He spent the next 15 minutes taking a selfie of himself and us on the Capitol steps. And then the last 10, 12 minutes, he just danced around the questions. And he put it on his Facebook. This is my favourite part of my day. And the Facebook, he probably never reads it. He's got interns or lackeys. But kind of a good lesson, really, to my guys and their mates. Because they just thought, what did my son call him? A sly, shitty bugger or something. Which I thought was quite eloquent. But anyway. Yeah, local politics in Eastern Washington. Okay. Where were we? Okay, so... should we carry on a bit longer? Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
I have a couple more at least. Okay, I've got one.
Okay, so I said I'd teach only part-time at the high school. Theatre. And I did it after school for 2 years as a drama club. But I changed the name, it's a drama company now. A bit more respectful. Anyway, the first couple of years I wrote plays with the students which had music in them. And the third year we became part of an English class and the English teacher, great guy, and we wrote a play and they banned it, obviously, because, you know, someone at the conservative end of the spectrum found part of the script and complained and the principal just basically caved. Anyway, but I don't think it was anything to do with us. They just sometimes have to throw a bone to that part of the community. The second year we wrote this play and it kind of like some of those songs I played earlier, the near future sci-fi. Anyway, this song grew out, and it's on the record, it grew out of one of the songs we did for the play. And one of the students sings on it on the record and one thing and another. Anyway, it goes like this. But it doesn't have that on it. What would Shakespeare do? To be or not to be, to be or not to be, whether 'tis hunger in the mind to suffer, the slings and arrows and reaper drums, the villains of the make an outrageous fortune from the suicide bomb on fossil fuel. To be or not to be, to be or not to be, nowhere to run, nowhere to hide, when the whole
Somebody, what, that, thanks to Left Bank Books, of course, thanks to the other performers, and sorry I forgot your name, Pines and Amorous and Logs Can Kill. Annie, you, at one point you said, I'll get out of your ass, and I thought, well, I don't, I'm in it. Anyway, someone else was thinking it, I know, probably. I don't know, maybe it's just a bald thing. Okay, I'll do a couple more. And then we'll call it a night. This is another one, actually. This is from the first play we wrote, which was like about gender roles, a lot of it. So it's funny, you know, the play about gender roles we got away with, kind of on the fence. The second play, which was like political, you know, like the world we're living in and what's getting worse. Third play, about. It was basically asking questions about monogamy and non-monogamy, and that's, you know, that were the kiss of death, unfortunately. Anyway. Sometimes it just goes out. There's a whole... Chemistry. Should know that, shouldn't I? Being in a high school. Belly of the sun, deep in the belly of the sun, deep in the belly of the sun. All the atoms dance, the proton connected to the neutron, the proton connected to the neutron, making as of the electrons. Everybody dance. like walking the plank, I do this occasionally. A new song that I wrote this week. So it is a total working process. Progress. You could say process, but progress. So it'll be a train wreck, no doubt. But, okay, and there's like an intro. They're listening to the beat again. And what are they hearing this sound? Oh, yeah. There's a market research program. There is, but it's gone. Anyway, okay.
Going up, oops, they're inviting, not this time, oh, but that's okay.
table. Audience participation, and luckily some of you snuck beer in here, not I, but it's like you just got to imagine you're like a drunken choir in a bar, or on a, not on a cruise ship because you'd probably throw up if the sea got rough, so there's a chorus and it's real simple, and I'll teach it to you now. You can just sing along. At the very end, I'll keep doing it. You guys, you ignore me and you just keep going. That's the key. That is the essential key to this audience participation. It's good. It's like, yeah. Anyway, okay. was a pleasure. And thanks for coming out. Thanks for playing, those of you who played, and enjoy the rest of the wonderful evening. Probably, hopefully. Anyway, okay. Yeah. I will go find some of that thing they call beer. Okay. Cool. Thanks.